Hi guys, my name is Sergey and I'm a car mechanic. Today I'm gonna show you how to change front brake pads, and I'm sure after watching this video you guys will be able to change front brake pads with flying color without any problem. We have Honda Element 2003, and let's start. I'm gonna show you what kind of tool do we need to get the job done. We actually don't need a lot of tools, guys. For this car we need 12 millimeter wrench or just 12 millimeter socket with ratchet. We need vise and we need simple flat screwdriver. We need grease for brake system and we need piece of simple wire. Let's start it. I will show you some tips, tricks, and give you some advices, guys, and how to do this job quicker and easier. And I will show some things which many people ignore when they change the brake pads. First, if you have automatic transmission, put at park position and apply the parking brake like this. Second, turn the ignition key in position number one. It will not turn ignition on, but it will let you turn the wheel around. First, loose your lug nut bolts. I will use a rack, but you guys, if you work on your garage or your driveway, you can use just floor jack, or you can use your jack which inside your trunk, your car, and you can put like some cone before and behind the wheel or simple piece of wood. It will help to keep your car more stable. Alright guys, our ignition key in position number one, and we can turn our wheel easy left and right side, and we turn it all the way left side, and now we have more access to disconnect our caliper. But before we take out the caliper, guys, I will show you small trick how to do it quicker and easier. Before we take this caliper out, let's push the piston inside. You can use simple flat screwdriver. Put the screwdriver inside the caliper and push over the brake disc, and you can see how the piston goes inside. Why I recommend do it before you take the caliper, because now do it much easier. Then if you take it out, after that you have to use special pliers or special vise to push the caliper inside. And now it's much easier to do it. Let's do it. Okay, now you can see that caliper moved a little bit, but it doesn't go all the way because our slide pin doesn't move anymore. Now you can change the screwdriver position and put it between the brake pads and our brake disc. And now you can push the caliper piston all the way in. Here we go. Now our piston pushed all the way inside the caliper, and you don't need to push it and play it after you take it out. While pushing the piston inside the caliper, guys, make sure that you have enough space in your reservoir, because you might overfill it. If there necessary, just suck out some fluid, because if you'll not do it, you'll spill all the fluid outside. Next step, we have to loose our caliper. I recommend lose one side and after lose another one. I don't recommend take always a bolt, because after that you try to lose this one and your caliper start to spin over, and it's a little bit not comfortable. This is why you lose both of them, just slightly lose them, and after then you can take them out. We'll lose one and we'll lose another one. Now you can take them out. Never let this hanging on the brake line, because you might damage it. This is why we can use a simple wire and bind it on suspension somewhere. Usually I bind on the springs like this, and now we can work with our brake pads. All right, we took the brake pads out. Now we take the hardware out. This small piece of steel holds our brake pads and make it tight, and our brake pads doesn't vibrate. Always, guys, many people ignore these things, but always clean this surface with simple steel brush. Clean and blow all the dust and rust. And now it's really important things, guys. This slide pins, which holds our caliper, sometimes many people ignore to open and clean them and put some new grease inside, because they try and they slide. You can see it's slide really well. Top side is slides, but bottom side is stuck. It doesn't move. And many people ignore it and never open, never clean it. I would hardly recommend every time open and clear this slide pin. I pushed really hard to get it out, because it's dry, the grease is dry, guys, you can see. And this one goes really well, but this one is all stuck. We should clean it with piece of rag. Also, I recommend clean inside as much as you can. You can use simple screwdriver, go inside and clean it. And use special grease. It's high temperature grease. I recommend always use special grease for brakes. We grease our pin with new grease. Put some grease on front and push it in. Here we go. Now our pin slides with flying color. All right, we cleaned and looped our slide pins, and now next step, we're gonna install the brake pads. I still waiting for new pads, and I just show you like example with old ones. We have out brake pads and we have inner brake pads. You can see difference. Just we have the indicator, which usually goes inside caliper side, because caliper side wear out a little bit quicker, and this is why usually it goes in at caliper side. And after your pads material wear out and our pin starts touch to the rotor, it makes scratching, squeaking noise, and you can hear it. And this is how you recognize that your brake pads is wear out, and you must replace them. Always, guys, use grease and grease all this surface which slides inside our caliper bracket. Like this. If you don't use the grease, it might size inside, it might push your brake parts a little bit crooked and wear it a little bit not even, or it might wear the outside or inside brake parts not evenly. This is why I recommend always use grease. Here we go. Alright, our brake pads in, everything is good, and now we can install our caliper. And it's really comfortable because we pushed this piston inside before we took it off. And now we can install it easy. Torque to this caliper bolts might be a little bit different, but usually it's around 25-30 Newton meter. You could see, guys, it was really easy. You don't need a lot of tools, you don't need a lot of experience, and I'm sure I showed you some tricks how to do it right and quickly and easy. And I'm sure after watching this video you'll be able to do it by yourself. Next video, guys, I will show you how to change rear brakes, more difficult, like drum system, or when your rear side has electric parking brake, and I will make video about that rear brakes. I'm really happy, guys, share my experience with you, and I will do it in future. This is why subscribe my channel, follow me on Instagram, write down below some comments and put your finger up. It will be small thanks for me. Share this video for your friends, and see you next time.